Welcome everyone. It is 3 p.m. and it's time for the Server Room Show. This is episode 85. This episode is dedicated to little Pocok, and she knows who she is. Today I want to talk about Microsoft DOS, and the reason being for that is one of the other days I was talking to my wife, and I asked her if she remembers anything from the DOS era, and she told me that pretty much the first time she came in contact with a computer at school, it was already this Windows, around this Windows 95 and similar. So this episode is for everyone out there, all of those who might have missed everything which happened before Windows came to the computer scene, and Microsoft DOS indeed is an important piece of history, an important recollection of computer history. So you know that there were things before Windows came to the scene, and one of these before Windows is Microsoft DOS. Microsoft DOS, acronym for Microsoft Disk Operating System, also known as Microsoft DOS, is an operating system for x86-based personal computers, mostly developed by Microsoft. Collectively, Microsoft DOS, its rebranding as IBM PC DOS, and some operating systems attempting to be compatible with Microsoft DOS are sometimes referred to as DOS in general, which is also the generic acronym for a disk operating system. Microsoft DOS was the main operating system for IBM PC compatible personal computers during the 1980s, from which point it was gradually superseded by operating systems offering a graphical user interface, GUI. In various generations of the graphical Microsoft Windows operating system, IBM licensed and re-released it in 1981 as PC-DOS 1.0 for use in its PCs, although Microsoft DOS and PC-DOS were initially developed in parallel by Microsoft and IBM. The two products diverged after 12 years in 1993, with recognizable differences in compatibility, syntax, and capabilities. During its lifetime, several competing products were released for the x86 platform, and the Microsoft DOS went through 8 versions until development ceased in 2000. Initially, Microsoft DOS was targeted at Intel 8086 processors running on computer hardware using floppy disks to store and access not only the operating system, but application software and user data as well. Progressive version releases delivered support for other mass storage media in ever greater sizes and formats, along with added feature support for newer processors and rapidly evolving computer architectures. Ultimately, it was the key product in Microsoft's development from a programming language company to a diverse software development firm, providing the company with the essential revenue and marketing resources. It was also the underlying basic operating system on which early versions of Windows ran as a GUI or a graphical user interface. Regarding the history of Microsoft DOS, Microsoft DOS was renamed form of 86 DOS owned by Seattle Computer Products, written by Tim Patterson. Development of 86 DOS took only 6 weeks, as it was basically a clone of Digital Research's CPM for 8080 and Z80 processors, ported to run on 8086 processors, and with two notable differences compared to CPM: an improved disk sector buffering logic and the introduction of FAT12 instead of the CPM file system. this first version was shipped in August 1980. Microsoft, which needed an operating system for the IBM personal computer, hired Tim Patterson in May of 1981 and bought 86 DOS 1.10 for $75,000 in July of the same year. Microsoft kept the version number but renamed it Microsoft DOS. They also licensed Microsoft DOS 1.10 /114 to IBM, which in August 1981 offered it as PC-DOS 1.0 as one of three operating systems for the IBM 5150 or the IBM PC. Within a year, Microsoft licensed the Microsoft DOS to over 70 other companies. It was designed to be an OS that could run on any 8086 family computer. Each computer would have its own distinct hardware and its own version of Microsoft DOS, similar to the situation that existed for CPM, and with Microsoft DOS emulating the same solutions as CPM to adapt for different hardware platforms. To this end, Microsoft DOS was designed with a modular structure with internal device drivers and the DOS BIOS, minimally for primary disk drives and the console, integrated with the kernel and loaded by the bootloader, and installable device drivers for other devices loaded and integrated at boot time. The OEM would use a development kit provided by Microsoft to build a version of Microsoft DOS with their basic I/O drivers and a standard Microsoft kernel, which they would typically supply on disks on disk to end users along with the hardware. Thus, there were many different versions of Microsoft DOS for different hardware, and there is a major distinction between an IBM compatible or ISA machine and the Microsoft DOS compatible machine. Some machines like the 10D2000 were Microsoft DOS compatible, but not IBM compatible, so they could run software written exclusively for Microsoft DOS without dependence on the peripheral hardware of the IBM PC architecture. This design would have worked well for compatibility if application programs had only used the Microsoft DOS services to perform device I/O. And indeed, the same design philosophy is embodied in Windows NT. You can see its hardware abstraction layer. However, in Microsoft DOS early days, the greatest speed attainable by programs through direct control of hardware was of particular importance, especially for games which often pushed the limits of their contemporary hardware. Very soon, an IBM compatible architecture became the goal, and before long all 8086 family computers closely emulated IBM's hardware, and only a single version of Microsoft DOS for a fixed hardware platform was needed for the market. This version is the version of Microsoft DOS that is discussed here, as the dozens of other OEM versions of Microsoft DOS were only relevant to the systems they were designed for, and in any case were very similar in function and capability to some standard versions for the IBM PC. Often the same numbered version, but not always, since some OEMs use their own proprietary version numbering schemes, for example labeling later releases of Microsoft DOS 1.x as 2.0 or vice versa, with a few notable exceptions. Microsoft omitted multi-user support from Microsoft DOS because Microsoft's Unix-based operating system Xenix was fully multi-user. The company planned over time to improve Microsoft DOS so it would be almost indistinguishable from single-user Xenix or Xidos, which would also run on the Motorola 68000, Zilog Z 8000, and the LSI 11. They would be upwardly compatible with Xenix, which Byte in 1983 described as the multi-user Microsoft DOS of the future. Microsoft advertised Microsoft DOS and Xenix together, listing the shared features of its single-user OS and the multi-user multitasking Unix-derived operating system, and promising easy porting between them. After the breakup of the Bell system, however, AT&T Computer Systems started selling Unix System 5, believing that it could not compete with AT&T in the Unix market. Microsoft abandoned Xenix and in 1997 transferred ownership of Xenix to Santa Cruz Operation SCO. On March the 25th, 2014, Microsoft made the code to SCP MS-DOS 1.25 and a mixture of Altos Microsoft DOS 2.11 and the Televideo PC DOS 2.11 available to the public under the Microsoft Research License Agreement, which makes the code source available but not open source as defined by Open Source Initiative or Free Software Foundation standards. Microsoft would later re-license the code under the MIT license on September 28, 2018, making these versions free software. As an April Fool's Day joke, in 2015, Microsoft Mobile launched a Windows Phone application called Microsoft DOS Mobile, which was presented as a new mobile operating system and works similar to Microsoft DOS. Versions, Microsoft licensed or released versions of Microsoft DOS under different names like Lifeboat Associates, Software Bus 86, aka SB-DOS, Compact-DOS, and CR-DOS, or Z-DOS, before it eventually enforced the Microsoft DOS name for all versions. But the IBM one, which was originally called IBM Personal Computer DOS, later shortened to IBM PC DOS. Competitors released compatible DOS systems such as Dr. DOS and PTS DOS that could also run DOS applications. In the former Eastern Bloc, Microsoft DOS derivatives named DCP, Disk Control Program 320 and 330 existed in the late 1980s. I can tell you I have not heard about these versions up until I read about in the Wikipedia article. So as far as I know and I remember, I was using the single Microsoft DOS 6.22, what was the latest, and was the latest from Microsoft before transitioning to Microsoft Windows and perhaps Microsoft DOS 5.0 at some point. But I never heard of these derivatives of DCP, disk control program, to be honest. It mentions that these were introduced or produced by an East German electronics manufacturer called Web Robotron. Robotron maybe sounds familiar to me, or I heard it somewhere, but I've not seen these DCP, disk control programs, 320 and 330. And just to mention or go through shortly some of the versions, Microsoft DOS 1.x. DOS 1.x was very limited in what it could do. It could start applications .com and .exe and could process batch files .bat. DOS 1.0 worked with 160 kilobyte floppies and did not support folders. All files had to be in the root directory. The command interpreter supported only the following commands: dir, type, copy, erase, rename, pause, and rem. No pipes, no redirection or device drivers were supported. The DOS API in 1.0 was very limited. The Microsoft DOS 1.25, the equivalent of PC DOS 1.10, was the first version licensed to OEMs beyond IBM or Seattle Computer Products. As mentioned before, some vendors labeled their versions of Microsoft DOS with different names and version numbers, and sometimes it can be a bit chaotic to figure out which Microsoft DOS version and an OEM numbered version refers to. For example, Microsoft DOS 1.11 from the OEM side, it's possibly a basis for IBM's personal computer DOS 1.0, compact DOS 1.12, and the compact OEM versions of Microsoft DOS 1.25 or higher. Or to look at another example, a version 1.24 OEM could be the basis for IBM personal computer DOS 1.1. So the version numbering of Microsoft and the OEM releases can be very different. Microsoft DOS, Microsoft DOS 2.x adds support for 5.25-inch 260 kilobyte floppy drives, user installable device drivers, and this is the first version to support folders and tree structurable file system. Remember that before in 1.x everything had to be in a single root folder. Microsoft DOS 3.x, DOS 3.0 adds support for FAT16 partitions up to 32 megabyte, 1.2 megabyte floppy drives, and the IBM 80 internal clock. Microsoft DOS 3.0x is extremely rare. After the release of IBM PC DOS 3.0, Microsoft dragged their feet, providing Microsoft DOS 3.x to other OEMs, possibly to appease IBM. Most OEMs didn't get Microsoft DOS 3.x until 3.1. Apricot and compact MS-DOS 3.0x versions are known to exist. Zenith and AT&T are suspected to exist. Microsoft DOS 3.20 is the first release offered as a vanilla box set directly to consumers, to end users, instead of just OEMs. So actually you could go and you were able to just go and purchase this as a boxed software for money. You didn't have to be an OEM to obtain or to get it as an OEM release via your computer you have purchased from the manufacturer like Compaq, for example, or IBM. Microsoft DOS 3.30 was a very popular version of Microsoft DOS due to the problems with 4.0 and 3.31 only being available via OEM channels. Many users stuck with 3.30 unless they needed a larger hard drive support, which came in Microsoft DOS 4.0 and later. Microsoft DOS 3.31, as just mentioned, was only sold through a few OEMs, mainly Compaq. This version adds support for hard drives up to 512 megabyte. It also does not use as much conventional memory as DOS 4.x or later, making it a good choice for 8088 and 8086 based computers. Version 3.0, OEM release, first version to support 5.25-inch 1.2 megabyte floppy drives and diskettes. Version 3.1, OEM support for Microsoft networks. Version 3.2, OEM first version to support 3.5-inch 720 kilobyte floppy drives and diskettes. Version 3.22 OEM, it's a release which also was available on the HP 95LX portable computer or PDA, however you want to call this. Version 3.3 OEM, the first version to support 3.5-inch 1.44 megabyte floppy drives and diskettes, OEM relays. Version 3.31 OEM adds support for FAT16B and larger drives. Microsoft DOS 4.0, Microsoft DOS 4 added support for hard drive partitions up to 2 gigabytes. It used much more of the base 640K and it was somewhat buggy and had bugs. Microsoft had long planned that Microsoft DOS 4 would be a multitasking capable operating system, but IBM had insisted on creating a new version of regular DOS for use with their PS2 computers. the developer versions as released to the consumer market are based on DOS 3.3x and IBM's PC DOS 4.0 enhancements, although essentially scraped some narrow European markets did receive Microsoft's multitasking Microsoft DOS 4.0. Again, I don't remember these ones. I will have to look them up on some abandonware or some other places. Microsoft's initial 4.0 release file dates of the 10th of June 1988, except if it's this date is in an American format, then it would make it to the 6th of October 1988. So I can't be sure of this date format here in the text, if it's US or European. It was quickly followed up by 4.01, making this an uncommon version, version 4.0. To add to the confusion, most OEMs badged their 4.01 disks as 4 or 4.0. So the real Microsoft 4.0 releases not that easy to come up with, because as you see, it was quickly followed by 4.01, and it's confusing that many OEMs batched their 4.01 as 4 or 4.0. So yeah, you do have to check those file dates, as I just mentioned, which I'm not sure if it's in a European or a US format. It includes a graphical mouse interface. It had many bugs and compatibility issues, this Microsoft DOS 4.0. 4.0 OEM first version to support a single hard disk partition that is greater than 32 megabyte and up to a maximum size of 2 gigabyte. Version 4.01 OEM, the one which quickly followed version 4.0, Microsoft rewritten version 4.0, released under Microsoft DOS label, but not IBM PC DOS. First version to introduce volume serial numbers when formatting hard disks and floppy disk. Disk duplication also, and when using SIS to make a floppy disk or partition of a hard drive bootable. Version 4.0 version 4.01A as an OEM, that was also one of the versions. Then we are on another big one, Microsoft DOS 5.0. Microsoft DOS 5, MS-DOS 5 introduced numerous new features and was a flagship release for Microsoft. A full screen text editor edit has replaced the former line editor Edlin, supplied since the early days of DOS. Microsoft QBasic also shipped in DOS 5, replacing GW Basic. Microsoft DOS 5 also supported 2.88 megabyte 3.5 inch floppy disks, as well as hard disks up to 2 gigabyte in size. The memory management was rewritten to allow DOS to utilize the high memory area and upper memory area to reduce its usage of conventional memory. Numerous bugs were noticed shortly after the launch, which led to the 5.0A update. This release of DOS was the last of the collaboration between Microsoft and IBM, and as a result will be the last result where PC DOS and Microsoft DOS are near identical. This was also the version of DOS used in the OS2 and Windows NT virtual DOS machine. When Microsoft DOS 5 was released, the entire market had become dominated by IBM and compatible systems. So specific OEM versions of DOS for machines not using an IBM BIOS were not shipped as in prior releases. Version 5.0 retail includes a full screen editor, a number of bugs required reissue. First version to support 3.5 inch 2.88 megabyte floppy drives and diskettes, as mentioned. hard disk partitions greater than 32 megabyte and up to a maximum size of 2 gigabyte. Was now provided by the Maxivdos kernel, first version to load portions of the operating system into the high memory area. So the hard disk partition support for greater than 32 megabyte and up to a maximum of 2 gigabyte was now provided by the MS-DOS kernel. AST Premium exec DOS 5.0, an OEM release, a version for the AST Premium exec series of notebooks with various extensions, including improved load high and extended code page support. Version 5.0a retail, with this release IBM Microsoft versions diverge. Version 5.50 Windows NT VDM, all Windows NT 32-bit version ships with files from DOS 5.0. Microsoft DOS 6.x. Microsoft DOS 6.0 includes many new utilities and features, including a disk defragmenter, disk compression, antivirus, a new backup system, and PC to PC file transfer tools. It was heavily criticized as buggy by the media, primarily due to file corruption issues with double space and the lack of tools to repair such issues. Note that the boot sector OEM ID of MS-DOS 6.0 is correct and genuine. Microsoft reverted to using MS-DOS 5.0 on later disks. Microsoft intentionally skipped 6.1 to prevent confusion with IBM's independently produced PC-DOS 6.1. Microsoft also made a free / inexpensive 6.0 to 6.2 step-up kit available. This update corrects some major bugs in double space, introduces scan disk, adds auto-mounting of compressed floppies and a tool to uncompress double space compressed drives. Microsoft DOS 6.21. This version was specifically released to remove double space due to legal injunction. The replacement drive space was not yet ready. We reached Microsoft DOS 6.22. Microsoft DOS 6.22 was the last standalone version from Microsoft. It was also the last from Microsoft to run on an 8080, 8086 or 286. 6.22 adds drive space, a replacement for DOS 6.20's double space drive compression that was removed in 6.21. There is a really detailed tutorial, I left a link in the show notes in the articles, that gives tips on how to customize DOS. It's a nice article, and I suggest you follow these tutorials for setting up and customizing DOS in a virtual machine or perhaps on a bare metal hardware of your choice. However, if you are installing to a virtual machine, writing the disk images to actual floppies is not going to be necessary, so you can omit that step from the tutorial. Version 6.0 retail, online help through QBasic, disk compression, upper memory optimization and an antivirus included. Version 6.2 scan disk as a replacement for check disk. Fix serious bugs in double space. Version 6.21 retail stacker infringing double space removed. Version 6.22 retail the new drive space compression is included. This is how far I got today in episode 85. I have a couple of more things to tell you about Microsoft DOS. I will continue on episode 86 with the second part, talking about the changes, because after 6.22 under the Microsoft Windows era of Microsoft DOS continued the localized versions. Some notable Microsoft DOS applications, or there were so many, maybe they were only notable for me, or I felt like mentioning them. Talking a little bit about the competition, and therefore legal issues, some MS-DOS modern alternatives of today, the ones you could still use, emulating Microsoft DOS in under Linux, Windows or Mac, and to how you can use it today, some of the undocumented APIs, and talking a little bit about the Windows command line and earlier Windows earlier versions of Windows which came with their MS-DOS interface. Then it became end of life, legacy compatibility, and some closing thoughts from me. Thank you very much. This was episode 85, Microsoft DOS, a dedicated episode to little Pocok, and she knows who she is. The one who is knows who it refers to. Thank you very much, and we will continue this episode the next Saturday in episode 86, part 2 of MS-DOS.